What's going on, guys? Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to Migos Code. Last week, ChatGPT just made a big storm, literally a big storm around the world. So within a week, they had more than 1 million subscribers onto their platform, which was insane. And with this, a lot of people are literally scared. ChatGPT is a prototype AI chatbot developed by OpenAI, which specializes in dialogue. And this tool is so powerful, and people are scared. So I've posted on Instagram a poll asking whether you are scared, and majority of people said, yes, I'm so scared. And I just thought, maybe let me just record this video to calm you down. Yo, listen, I'm worried about you, man. ChatGPT, you said that it's gonna take your job.
I was a bit worried at first. The whole process of the AI doing the job of the developer. You know how, like, you ordered it to create a API to do with the customer, and it was there. It was just making it.
Right.
It shows you the potential.
I see. Literally, as you saw with Saleh, he's scared because, you know, he's coming into the field, he's brand new, he doesn't know much about it. And you are missing the point with ChatGPT. Literally, you are missing the point. Now, the fact that ChatGPT, it seems like I'm saying B. Oh, ChatGPT. ChatGPT literally can write code for you. Like, you can say, do you know what? Write me a CRUD REST API in Spring Boot using services, repositories, you name it. And it will go and basically write the code for you. Now, Saleh was saying, do you know what? That took me like a week to write, and this thing is just writing it within seconds. That is insane, right? Now, I would say, yes, it's absolutely insane, but it's not going to replace your role as a developer. There's a bunch of people recording videos saying, oh, it's going to replace you as a developer and whatnot, and you are missing the point of ChatGPT. ChatGPT is your assistant. Think of it as a tool that will speed up your development. So the same with IntelliJ or an IDE. Why do we need IDEs? We need IDEs because it helps us to write code faster. The integration, the tools, the debugger, all of that stuff helps us as an engineer to be more productive. The same thing with ChatGPT, literally is the same thing. The fact that you could just say, do you know what? How do you do this in Python? How do you do this in Go? Or how do you do XYZ in a certain programming language? The fact that you can do that and it will spit out some code for you is just mind blowing, because now here I'm thinking about all the possibilities of putting software out there without actually having to, one, ask Stack Overflow. So you've seen that even Stack Overflow, they've banned answers from ChatGPT, which is insane. So instead of me going on Stack Overflow and reading blogs and whatnot, I could just use the tool to give me some code. And let's be honest, software engineers, we do still a bunch of code, whether it's from Stack Overflow, GitHub, you name it, we steal a bunch of code from the internet. Now, having a system that will help us in writing code is just, wallahi, it's amazing, I'm telling you. One thing which I was actually impressed was Terraform. I used to do a bunch of Terraform when I was a DevOps engineer, and I was like, do you know what, write me some Terraform code that will give me an EC2 inside of ASG auto-scaling group. And what it actually did was it created the EC2, it put inside of the ASG, it gave me the AMI, it gave me the launch configuration, it gave me the whole thing. Now for that, like, it's amazing, because we know that Terraform is just configuration. It's not something that you memorize. So there's a bunch of resources and you don't memorize YAML. Literally no one does it, right? So if you need it, then you just go to the documentation and you get what you want. You customize it according to your needs. Now, ChatGPT, it's amazing at doing that. It's just think about it, right? So ChatGPT, it's AI. And AI, as Marcus Brownlee was saying the other day, he said that AI doesn't have something that we humans have, and that is imagination. And when we build software, there's a bunch of stakeholders involved. We've got back-end developers, front-end developers, we've got DevOps, we've got QA analysts, we've got testers, we got Scrum Masters. The whole shebang, really, in terms of building software is amazing. There's a lot of people involved. Now, obviously, you can't really trust an AI to build you, you know, an enterprise application that makes millions, and it just doesn't work like that, right? So it's just an assistant to help you in your development workflow. It's just amazing. And even though ChatGPT spits out some code, you as an engineer, you need to understand exactly what has been given out to you. So imagine that ChatGPT is giving you malicious code. Like, you can't just trust the code that is given to you. So you still have to read the code. You still have to make sure that it indeed does what it's supposed to do. And as an engineer, you need to know what are the edge cases that ChatGPT didn't manage to solve. So you still need to understand the code yourself. You are not irreplaceable. Don't think that you're just going to lose your job because of ChatGPT. Seriously. Stop. Now, one thing which I couldn't get it to do was to actually fix bugs. So a lot of people were saying, oh, you know, you can throw a bug and it will fix some code for you. Now, if it's like something really simple, like if, and then you've missed the less or greater than sign, then probably yes. But if it's something more complex, so I had an example where I forgot to close the stream. So I was doing something with Golang and it just said, you know, I'm not qualified to fix bugs, right? So your job is not at risk, I can guarantee you. I don't know what this thing will look like in about 5 to 10 to 15 years, because we've just seen what it's been able to do. And obviously, it can become smarter, and the more data that we feed into it, the better it gets. I literally don't know what is the full potential of this tool, but one thing for sure that I will tell you is that this is the perfect time for you to start to make money. Literally, like, go on Fiverr. You'll see a bunch of people paying to write maybe blogs or talk about a product or literally just anything that has to do with copywriting maybe. Like, you could use this to help you make money. YouTube automation, maybe you wanted to talk about something, a topic, and it will go off and basically talk to you. And it's like having a conversation, and that is the beauty of it. It's like you are talking to it and it's giving you like real answers, and you're like, do you know what? It's insane, right? So I think that you shouldn't really panic at this point, because obviously, as I said, building software, it's a huge process. So this is my view on ChatGPT. I think that you shouldn't really panic. And yeah, comment down below and let me know, you know, what do you think about this tool? Are you excited? Are you still scared? Like, hopefully you're not scared at this point. And yeah, if you enjoyed this video, literally take 1 second and smash that like button. And I'll catch you in the next one. Assalamu alaikum.